Hello guys, Zuljan here, and welcome to another episode of Decorating a Modern Apartment Building that Corrales Built. I'm happy to have you with me here today. I have a fresh kitchen design that I'd like to show you. A little bit out of what I've been doing, and I'm hoping that you guys like it. I really don't know about the living room and the layout. It's something that I really, really need to work on. The more and more I do these decorating gigs for places that I'm not familiar with, the more I realize that layout is really a challenge for me. But it's something that'll come in time, I suppose. I just need to do a little bit of research on it and really find out some different methods or look at some house plans or something. I'm really not sure. Usually how I do is room by room, and when you're decorating a house, it's a little bit different. So especially this open floor plan, it's something that's pretty hard to get right, and plus spacing has always been an issue with me in Minecraft. So some weak areas, everybody has them, I suppose. I might as well admit to them. Anyway, so I've got this little kitchen design that I've been thinking about, and I played with it a little while, and I actually like it a lot. There is a couple things that I'd like to do, namely I want to change these out to quartz pillars. And I'll have that stretch out all the way over here. And with this, it kind of just gives it a little added flair. You know, some more lines to look at, which I really like lines and designs like that. It really looks really good. We could probably do a sink right here with stairs. And we'll have to do it like so. There we go, a nice little sink. And right here, probably some curtains, I would think. So let's see if we, I don't think I have a banner. Let's just look for a banner, and I can change that out with, I don't think I'll need this right away. And, we'll also move this for now. Well, actually let's move the stairs for now, cause I don't think I need that. And I'll use birch in item frames to signify kind of like, almost like a little curtain rod here. And I'll just turn them at an angle like this, and then I'll put the white banners on them. There we go. Nice little curtain set up there. I think I'll do a lever right next to this to kind of act like a faucet. I suppose I could do a tripwire hook too, but I like tripwire hooks in different applications for this. Now, the separation for this is pretty cool. I can easily do something like maybe a little coffee pot right here, and I can also do, let's see, I can do some signs right here to kind of emulate some sort of cubby. I think that would work out well. Yeah, almost like a little shelf, something to put it in, something to put something in right there. Or we could do some item frames right here as well. And something, I've learned a trick very, very recently from, let's see, the name of the guy is Acrobaticon. I couldn't ever get it right. So he uses empty maps. He did a tutorial a while back with some empty maps and item frames that just showed it as an oversized deal. And I really, really love the way they look. They have so many different applications. Like for this section, for instance, let's take this out and do some lighting right here. Let's see, we'll go with glowstone for this. Actually, we could do sea lanterns as well. Let's try sea lanterns for this specific application. I think I'm finished with that for now. So we can put the sea lanterns here, and this will be like a little area that we're going to cook or prepare food at. And what I could probably do is do maybe like a little, kind of like a little setup for a an oven here. Oh no, that's not what I want. I don't want them to face up like that. There we go, facing back, that works out. And then we'll do, the little stove hood can work into here. So we'll actually take that out and we'll do something like this. Yeah, there we go. That looks more like a stove hood. That's what I was hoping for. We can actually do this right here. And I want to do a little microwave, and the way that I'm going to do that is, I think I'm going to do it, we could probably do it right here. It's a little bit close to here. I maybe should have did the stove one over. It's just a little tight fit. Let's see if we can do a microwave here. So if I took two regular blocks, any type of blocks, I'm going to use the quartz though, because that's what we're working with right now. And if I did the item frame right here, no, because that vent hood touches on it. I might have to move this over. Let's see. Let's take this exact same setup here and do that. There we go. And it kind of does some trickery with the lighting. If I did a light right back there instead, how would that make it look? That actually works out pretty well. So I can come with it just like this. And instead of having that there, we can just do that here. Perfect. I like that. Okay. So that works out pretty good. Let's change this back to this. And now we can properly do the microwave. All right. So the microwave, we can do maybe a couple of the... did I have this one more down? Did I have it like that? I think I only had... I want to say this would probably look better as a vent hood. Maybe. Yeah, because that kind of does like the cabinet thing. What happens if I put item frames on these and use these oversized maps? Actually, we can do something like that. That actually looks pretty good, almost like cabinets, but it takes away from the fact that it's a it takes away from the fact that it's actually a vent hood. I think we'll use these item frame patterns for the microwave instead. So let's go ahead and fill these in just like we were doing before, and then I'll put the... There we go. All right. So now we're good with that. Right here, we're going to do the microwave. Let's just do like some shelving units. We'll do the quartz blocks. Actually, we need to do the quartz blocks like this. And this will go underneath. And this will be like what the microwave stands on. We can also do some right on top. And that would give it a little bit more texture. And then we can do the item frames here. And let's do... I think we can just use this, right? We can probably use a button. Let's see, we'll use a stone button for now. We'll use a stone button on this side. Actually, can we do it on that side? Yeah, that'll probably work. And then we'll do the same thing with item frames all around. And hopefully... Oh, that's not what I wanted. There we go. Oversized item frames look really, really, really good in this application. So that's like the little microwave. I like that. Now for these, we can do drawers and at the bottom. And I've seen this a lot in World of Corrales. Kind of a setup sort of like this. And then we can actually do the same thing right here. All right, I think that works out pretty well. And here we can actually do a couple of the cabinet doors like we've been doing. So let's take, it's gonna look a little weird with these kind of doors, but we're gonna do it anyway. We'll have a door here and a door here. There we go. And then we can go with some sort of wool on top or carpet on top. Let's do white carpet. And that ought to just change it just a smidge right here. Yep, and in the back, we won't be able to have that there, but that's okay. Actually, if we made that like a... We can do probably two pieces of wood right here to make like a cutting board, I think. And we can do a small item frame in the back. Oh, no, we can't fit an item frame in the back on that one because of this setup right here. What happens if we took this away? That still kind of looks like a sitting microwave. I think I like that better, actually. And on top of here, we can do a little bit better now. So let's take... I don't know, we'll do a wooden pressure plate. Can we do a pressure plate? Yeah, we'll do a pressure plate right here. Actually, let's do a pressure plate right here, and then we can just finish that off with white all around. That way it'll, well, we'll only do it on this side. So that just looks like a food preparation area now. Now if I take my item frame and put probably a, let's see, we'll go with the iron sword because that looks most like a knife. There we go. And probably, we can probably set some item frames back here as well. So if we did item frame, item frame, item frame, item frame, and two more here and one more there, we can do a little bit of... I think we're going to use this as the handles for the cabinets because we can tilt them in a way that they kind of look like they're paired up. I think that works out pretty darn well. And these would be like, or we can do drawers with these actually. So if we did these just like that, they look a little bit like, a little bit more like drawers. So that works out pretty well. Make that one more rotation. And so far, that's a pretty cool looking kitchen, if I do say so myself. I like that. Now, I'm not particularly fond of these cabinets right here, so we're probably going to do the same thing as we had earlier, and let's just do the quartz right here instead. We're still going to use this section just like this right here, because I'd like a little bit of light back there. So let's take one of these lamps. There we go. And that's just a little bit more light back there, and all in all, that looks pretty good. How about buttons on the stove? We'll do a couple of buttons here. And we'll also do some... will I be able to put rail on top of this this setup right here? Ah, sure will. Okay, that's going to be like the grill. That works out really, really well. I'm happy with that. Now all I need is weighted pressure plates for up front. And we'll have ourselves some bona fide burners. Bam and bam. All right. So this kitchen is a good little different design that I haven't been really implementing. And I kind of like it, to tell you the truth. The wooden cutting board could be a little out of place. I could just make it like that. But you can always add a wooden cutting board here and there if you wanted to. Let's add it right here next to the sink. I actually typed in cutting board. That's funny. Pressure plate. It's funny what you get used to. Alright, so we could do like the cutting board there, and we can actually do the knife right there as well. Sword. Bam. Just like this. There we go. That's a nice little cutting board. And this back area here, there's not much that I could do with that. I could do like that little paper towel dispenser. Let's see if there's anything else I could do. Maybe I could do a cauldron, and that would kind of look like a stovetop pot that would be being stored right here. So, oh, that's not what I wanted to do. How about it's stored right here? There we go. That's like a little stovetop pot. We can put that actually right here. Oh. There we go. So it's like sitting on the stove, ready to go. Not bad. I think I like this. I think I like this a lot. We can even do, we can do the same design here with a shovel, and maybe make that like a spoon. How about this? Shovel. This would kind of look like a spoon, wouldn't it? It kind of looks like a shovel. And there's really no fork. No, that's good. I kind of like the way that is, just like that. I wish this would be a little bit more detailed here, but it's impossible to do that. Maybe we could just go with these oversized item frames again and see how that goes. No, regular old seems to do the trick. Yeah, that'll work. Just the empty space right here. Okay, so as far as the kitchen goes, that's pretty much good. Now, the living room is something else. So I could do a little island right here, which I think would be a good, I don't know, it would, I think it would be a good little addition. We can do a little island right here, and actually, we can make this thing just like, almost like a full structure in the room. Let's see. This would almost be like, I would say, almost like a snack bar type deal. So we'd have to put a couple chairs. Kinda think I like that idea. So if we did just some chairs right here, it would look a little bit out of place. We could make it a little bit higher. So what about a slab? What about quartz slabs right here? And if we took this out, and well, actually, let's take that out instead. Is that on the same one? Yeah, I get lost. All right, and let's get rid of this too. We'll put another one right here, so we can still see. We'll put a few of them. How about that? All right. So now we have this, and I can easily make these stairs as well. So this would almost be like a snack bar. That's a cool shape. And I think I could probably do a good little deal with the natural chair design that we use. Let's go with fence. We'll go with a birch fence like that. And we'll do one here. We could do, actually, well, we can't do four because they stick together. What happens if we would place, oh no, the walls would stick together too, huh? That doesn't work either. Okay, hold on. And this would be too close, I'm afraid. Or would it be? Would that be too close? That is a little tight. That is a little tight, I'm afraid. So yeah, the chairs are just going to be off-center. That's okay. We'll do chairs on either side. Actually, we'll do chairs like this. And we can do a chair right there, too, if we wanted to. Let's do those weighted pressure plates on top, just like this. And now we can do the item frames on the back. Just like so. And we can actually make those bigger with the maps. And how's that look from the other end? Yeah. Man, this map trick, I gotta tell you, I am in love with it. This is just beautiful. Look at that. It's some full-size chairs. Really, really, really good stuff. I love it. Okay, so now that we have this little section laid out, this is a little bit higher than the rest of the kitchen, which is okay. I mean, that's all right. It kind of makes me think that we should do like a little rug here. And what about this area? So now I kind of need to section this off for, I guess, a couch. But really, we don't need a couch. I mean, I should probably... It all seems a little bit too much like it's going to intrude on anything that I do put here. I suppose I could do maybe a little office setup here, but... I think a dinner table would probably be nicer, even though, man, the snack bar is kind of... I don't need a dinner table at all with the snack bar the way it is right there. So maybe if we did just a couch, let me think about this for just a few minutes. All right, guys, I've been staring at this stuff for a little while, and I think the best thing would be to kind of separate the rooms a little bit. I just put this in thinking about light placement. I think what I'm going to do is go ahead at top right here. And go all the way across with quartz. And that would give a little bit of separation to the two segments that we already have. This area is looking really, really dark now. Okay, let's try to get some light in here in, I guess, the most non-intrusive way possible. We got three on this side, three on that side. It should be centered right here. So let's grab... I kind of need all of this stuff. Let's go ahead and grab a sea lantern and put that here. And then what we can do is stairs, I guess. Let's see. Dark oak stairs. And we'll just surround it right like this. Kind of like we did some of the other lighting. And that just makes it look a little bit less, I don't know, out of place. Okay, now it actually looks like a fixture of some sort. We can actually do this here too, I believe. And I would be perfectly happy with that lighting. For supplemental lighting, at least. Okay. So now that we have that little bit of lighting, I think what we ought to do... I was looking at some open floor plans on the internet, and I think we should probably do something like a television here. So let's do some barrier blocks. I guess... we're going to do one of those long paintings that we used for televisions. I can't remember if it's four or five. I got a place to make it look right. But we'll try a couple of paintings here. I think you have to do it off center by one. Yeah, there we go. All right, is that four enough? Over. If I do that one more there. Yeah, I guess this is as good a place as any. It's not quite the right distance, but yeah, I think that'll work. Okay, and we're going to use glass panes for kind of like a glass stand, if you will. I think that works out pretty good. That looks like a good little TV stand. And now I want to do some seating, but it won't be like real sophisticated seating. It's probably just going to be a couch right here and maybe a small chair next to it. I'm probably going to do a rug in this section here, and that would probably make sense. I fooled around with moving this inward too. That's one of the reasons why I don't have the rug there anymore. And I think it's I think it didn't do right. Like, I wasn't happy with it. So let's see. Yeah, a couple notch rug right here ought to be good. Let's see. We can also do another little rug right here, and that just brings a little bit of difference to it. Let's do some gray in the middle just to make it look like a little rug. How about that? That's a good little rug pattern, I think. Yeah, there we go. We'll do one more right there. Okay, that's a good little rug pattern. And right here, we'll do a little bit different kind of a seat. Now, I know I always do the seats with the stairs and the banners, but I just want to show you all some different ideas. How about this? Let's take some of these, and we can do this instead. And then we can come up top like this, and we can actually use the quartz for the back part, and let's add some arms. That works out pretty well. I think if I would have done it with the stairs, it would have looked a little bit different, unless I would have put white, and I don't want to have to put white against the outside right here. So yeah, that ought to work really well. Does that leave us enough room for a chair? No, not really. Let's come out by one more right here instead. And how's that? There we go. So now we just came out by one, and now we'll do the typical chair that we're used to doing. Do I have any stairs? Oh, I have some right here. I always try to pick blocks when I can because it's a little bit easier. Let's do... There we go. So now we have a couple different chairs. I really can't do the same type right here because just of the... I suppose I could. I could do like this and then go on top right here. We could put like a little table on this side. Let's put a bookshelf right here. We'll try to keep the same style of furniture going. We'll put a bookshelf right here, and we'll put a flower pot on top. Flower pot with our trusty, I don't know, let's go dandelion this time. We'll go flower pot, dandelion. Will that go in? Yeah, there it goes. Apparently I can't shift click it. Okay, and we need some sort of little table in between. I wonder if the black glass, did that place? That's weird. It was invisible for a second there. Okay, so it doesn't want to place just like that. If I put it right there, I think that would look kind of weird. What about one of these? It's been a while since I've done anything like this, but it's a pretty good design sometimes. We could do the lever here, and we can do the wool on top. No, that joins. Okay, we're going to go without a table right there. I'm actually going to take a piston. Let's do a little plant. We'll do a little plant feature right here and some leaves. We'll do the dark oak leaves. How do they look in this pack? Let's see. Yeah, that doesn't look too bad. It kind of breaks it up some. I'm thinking that it should just stay separate though. But we do need some, well, I can't really have it like that because it does show. What if we did something like this? Well, now that kind of looks like a sectional, doesn't it? I don't think I like that at all. Let's just kill that. I think we're just going to have to go with the regular wood, guys, because it's going to look weird if I don't. All right, so this is the comfy chair, and that's this is the comfy couch, and that's the not so comfy chair. That's about all I could do with it. Okay, so now I think I want to do some shelving designs in the back just to give the wall some character without just putting paintings. And a cool way to do that is by using quartz stairs. Since the textures are so seamless, you can do some pretty cool stuff. So if we poke a hole right there, naturally there's nothing back there, so that's pretty cool. And right here there is something behind it, so we would have to change it. And then we can go right on top and kind of do the same thing right here. And that creates like a funky little shelf design. Although I think I'd rather it facing the other way. Let's see if we could just pair it up here. So we'll go just like this and like that. And then if we go like this and like that, oh wait, why does that not, what did I do wrong here? I think I messed up here. It's supposed to be, there we go. Right, that's pretty cool. Okay, so we did that, and now down here we really can't do anything, except we could turn that in. That is gonna make it go, oh, we could do that. That's a pretty cool design right there. And now we can do a small painting here, which, do I have any room to spare back here for light? It doesn't look like, I could do some light right there. No, I'm gonna need glowstone here. Let's do glowstone in a painting. And this will just add a little bit to that side there, because I want to put a painting on that side as well. So yeah, painting 2x1 works in here, and the painting 1x2 ought to work really, really good right here. That's the same one as we have in the other room there. I don't want it to touch the top. It has to be a 2x1. That's kind of a weird painting. And we already have that one in use. I don't guess we have that much flexibility when it comes down to it, really. Yeah, we'll go with the green. That seems like a pretty good setup there. Now, our plant features that we were talking about, we could still do a couple of them in here. Actually, we could do one right here, and probably one when you just walk in to kind of break up the room. Let's go with that dark oak that we had before. Dark, there. I like those leaf colors. Really, really nice. Okay, we'll do that one too high, and we'll do this one too high as well. And what else can we add here? We could do like a little corner work desk. I don't know how this would look if I would actually join this up. How about this? That would give us a little bit of extra space. Yeah, actually, I think that's more acceptable than it was earlier. By the way, I know I got some comments on the knife and the pliers and stuff. It's meant to be a toy box, you guys. Sheesh. Okay, so I don't think I need anything more for seating area here. Although, instead of like an office desk, I think just a bigger bookcase would probably do good. So we'll go ahead and add that. Or we could do like a shelving unit, I suppose. I wonder if these things will stick to barrier blocks. Let's see. And wool. Carpet. What could I do? Let's do white carpet and just see something. I'm curious. So if we did that, and then we did that and that. Oh man. That is pretty nice. I think it would probably be better if we used a different color carpet. So let's see. What about gray carpet right here? Let's try gray carpet. And instead of this piece of wood, we'll use gray wool. Gray wool. All right, then we'll put this back. All right, how's this gonna look? That's the question. So let's put a couple more barrier blocks. Oh, we won't be able to put barrier blocks here. Okay, so if we went with gray wool on top, does that actually, can I actually still apply the item frames? No, I cannot. Unfortunately, it will not take the item frames. Boy, that would have been cool though, right? That would have been so great. Okay, so we're just gonna have to change our approach here. We could do like a small shelving unit instead with just some stairs and those for the sides. So I think that's what we're gonna do. I just messed this up. And yeah, regular old quartz, if I can get myself through the hole again. There we go. Oh gosh, all right. So instead of that, we'll do the dark oak slabs and we'll just do like a little shelving unit here, okay? So we'll come out here, 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 and this'll, I don't know if I'll be able to do it like that. I probably need to do it on the opposite end because it won't end well at the top. So if I did like this, that ends at the top. That works pretty good. Okay, and now I can take my item frames and put them all along the sides here with this new map fixture here that I got. Look at that. Very, very nice. I like that. It's a cool little shelf and I can even do a plant feature on top if I wanted to. Let's do a flower pot. Flower pot right here. Just like that. I think I like that. Cool. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed the little build. When we come back next time, we'll probably have a toy around with, I don't know, maybe some different designs for the patio and stuff. There's a few things that I have not done yet, like this little room here. I don't know what we could do. This could be like a little washroom, maybe like a washer and dryer and a countertop, and this could go into maybe some patio furniture and stuff. But that's gonna be it. Thank you guys so much for watching. As always, this is Uljin signing off, and we'll see you next time. Bye.